So now that you've watched the ad, consider these two approaches. Glenn takes an objective approach. The objective approach is based on the assumption that truth is singular and accessible through unbiased sensory observation. This approach is committed to uncovering cause and effect relationships. Using the objective approach, Glenn argues that MasterCard is convinced that Manning's celebrity appeal will rub off on the public image of their credit card. He looks at a dimension called source credibility, the perceived competence and trustworthiness of a speaker or writer that affects how the message is received. Hovland and Weiss argue that expertise and trustworthiness are two main ingredients of perceived credibility. Kelman argues that when people forge a body of identification with a figure like Manning, they'll gladly embrace his persuasive pitch. Identification involves the perceived role relationship that affects self-image and attitudes. It's based partly on attractiveness of the role model and is sustained if the relationship remains salient or important. So do viewers transfer Manning's expertise from the gridiron to the credit cards? Glenn would argue, I would want an objective test to find out if celebrity appeals really work. Is this ad campaign followed by an increase in new card applications or number of charges to those cards? Glenn would like to test whether the ad has some effect on viewers who do not know who Manning is, so you can compare that to those viewers who can identify with Manning as a celebrity. The interpretive approach is characterized by the linguistic work of assigning meaning or value to communicative texts. It assumes that multiple meanings of truths are possible. MasterCard uses Manning in an attempt to identify manliness with money. This commercial invites the viewer to become part of a team being constructed by Coach Manning. Marty chooses to use the lens of Burke's dramatistic pentad, the five-pronged method of rhetorical criticism that is used to analyze a speaker's persuasive strategy: the act, scene, agent, agency, and purpose. The ad starts with confusion. It moves through pain and destruction and arrives at manliness, money, and acceptance. A symbolic transformation has taken place. Marty argues that Manning is coaching the right attitude. It's the symbolic equivalence established between being manly and being in the money. The objective approach and interpretive approach to communication differs clearly in starting point, method, and conclusion. Glenn, the social scientist, works hard to be objective. Marty, the rhetorical critic, also works hard in his interpretive study. Most interpretive scholars are humanists, but a growing number of postmodern communication theorists reject that tradition. Humanistic scholarship is the study of what it is like to be another person, in another time and place, and it assumes there are a few important pan-human similarities, these similarities that reach across the entire human race. The separate worldviews of interpretive scholars and scientists reflect contrasting assumptions about the ways we arrive at knowledge, the core of human nature, questions of value, and the purpose of methods of research. Epistemology is the study of the origin, nature, method, and limits of knowledge. Epistemology is how we know what we know. Scientists assume truth is singular. Interpretive scholars regard truth as socially constructed through communication. Human nature, determinism or free will. Determinism is an assumption that behavior is caused by heredity and environment. Scientists stress forces that shape human behavior, in other words, biology and environment. Interpretive scholars focus on conscious choices made by individuals. Most social scientists place high value on objectivity that is not biased by ideological commitments. Interpretive scholars believe the ability to choose separates humanity from the rest of creation and value scholarship that extends free choice and emancipation. Emancipation is liberation from political, economic, racial, religious, or sexual oppression. In other words, empowerment. Deeds claims that every general communication theory has two priorities: effectiveness and participation. As a behavioral scientist, Glenn works to pin down universal laws of human nature that cover a variety of situations. As a behavioral scientist, theory testing is a basic activity. As a rhetorical critic, Marty strives to interpret a particular communication text in a specific context. He explores a web of meaning that constitutes human existence. When you understand what each type of theorist is about, you expand your comfort zone, and your confusion tends to diminish. Meta-theory is theory about theory, stated or inherent assumptions made when creating. Both the interpretivist view and the objectivist view seek to improve society in their own way. Here is a diagram indicating the nature of the theories covered in our textbook. Objectivist dots and interpretive dots indicate the perspective that the theory advances. Here's a diagram indicating which theories come from which tradition. Those from the objectivist tradition or interpretive tradition are clearly marked with the dots by each theory. Some theories fall in between, but most theories can be characterized as either more objective or interpretive. The two in the middle are symbolic convergence theory and generalistic styles.